Matt, what about this Blackwater faith-based training?
Yeah,
in the hell is this about?
Well, what in the holy hell is this about?
Yeah,
so Blackwater's latest venture is the training of faith-based organizations. And let's be accurate here, though, Pat. Blackwater, again, it's no longer Blackwater, like the artist Prince.
Yeah.
They're the mercenaries formerly known as Blackwater.
Yeah.
They changed their name to Z, and then they changed it again to U.S. Training Center,
right.
You know, hoping no one notices they're the same immoral war profiteers.
Right.
I mean, they changed their name
more
often.
And then they got Greystone.
Yeah, it's Greystone.
You know,
they change their name more often than P. Diddy does.
Well, I mean, when you're always like one step behind an indictment, I guess it's a pretty good policy.
You have to just keep.
Tom DeLay maybe should do the same thing.
Exactly.
You know?
Well, I mean, if you're on Dancing with the Stars, it's kind of hard to hide when you're you know dancing
right.
around like that.
You know right where he is. Okay, so tell me about this story.
Okay.
It's kind of creepy. It's very
it's,
everything.
It's very
look,
creepy.
Everything around Blackwater's creepy, but this is particularly creepy.
Totally. So The faith-based training is under the subsidiary or front group called Greystone. And it's the training is specifically called the Personal Security Awareness Program, or SAP, because the P is silent. So SAP here, it's like environmental and like vehicular training for companies and organizations that are going to be doing business, say, in a country that doesn't really want them there. I mean, you know, you expect Blackwater to be involved with corporations that are going into countries and robbing them blind, right?
Yeah,
I mean,
right.
Mercenaries,
right.
That makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
But the faith-based side of this also kind of makes sense if you're familiar with Blackwater's founder, Eric Prince.
Well, and then also if you're familiar with some of these faith-based operations that go into these third world countries.
Totally.
And understand they ain't that different from robbing the locals blind.
Of course not. But probably know Eric Prince. He's this hardcore Christian fundamentalist. He's in sworn court affidavits, Pap, he's been described as a man who sees himself as a Christian crusader tasked with eliminating Muslims and the Islamic faith from the globe.
Yeah, now those are his words.
Those are his words.
Yeah.
It's in a court affidavit.
Yeah.
And so in Iraq, you know, you had Blackwater soldiers using call signs for the Knights of Templar, you know, from the Crusades.
Yeah.
Okay, so now they're offering these training for faith-based organizations. I'm thinking maybe they can also provide, you know, weapons that are specifically tailored for the faith-based community, like maybe bayonets with crosses on them, like righteous rifles, like holy Humvees.
But he's doing business with it. I mean, he really is bringing in the business, isn't he?
Oh, totally. And however, though, their favorite weapon, Pap, though, it's the Bible. But it's not just any Bible, Pap. It's a Bible with a room hollowed out inside for a gun.
Yeah, I mean, that's basically what this whole thing sounds like. I mean, okay, so he brings over, I mean, these are basically Christian crusaders. I don't know how else to put it. I mean, would this be the Roberts, Pat Roberts kind of groups that want to go into Colombia or wherever and start missionaries?
Exactly. I think that he's trying to branch out to that has a natural tie with the right wing.
But he's made the statement he wants to kill all the Muslims. He wants to Islamic faith wiped from the globe.
Exactly. I mean, so any organization that would dare to have themselves, you know, associated with that, it already questions their simple morality there, that they can't really be godly people if they're willing to associate themselves.
Tell me
with
about
that.
Some of the sessions. He's broken it down into sessions, like, you know, session three, it caught my attention, teaches rules of the road.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of it is like, pretty much, I mean, it sounds like it's what it is. It's like environmental training where, I mean, the first session is when they look around to try to see, like, know your environment, know the people around it. It's just pretty much, it's security training. And then the second one is pretty much they have, like actually for, like, drivers who would be driving people around, like, how do you specifically avoid, you know, people who are trying to kill you in these countries.
Yeah.
But again, maybe they shouldn't necessarily be there in the first place if the population wants them dead. But here's the sick thing, though, here, Pap, is, okay, so when we talk about Blackwater, and a lot of people associate it with Bush, but Blackwater is still in Iraq.
Oh, I know.
It's still in Afghanistan. They're still being paid millions.
Yeah,
by the Obama
this whole thing about we're about change is meaningless when you take a look. Here, this session three, teaching rules of the road, specific driving. I mean, you know, it's kind of like what I heard you say. If you're trying to convert Muslims in a Muslim country, I guess you really have to be on guard because Muslims aren't too happy about that, are they?
I mean, there's a little bit of historical significance to the whole Crusades thing. So yeah, I think they pretty much would probably want to avoid it. And what's funny though is like, oh, so, you know, Congress has never passed a bill saying that Blackwater should not receive another dime. The same, unfortunately, though, can't be said for, say, Acorn. Now, I mean, the whole, you know, we have the whole Acorn video scandal here, right, Pap? And,
Wait, before we go that, I want to back up here just a second.
Sure.
Right now, you have the U.S. Justice Department that has a 34-count indictment against Blackwater.
Correct.
That's for the Nassau Square massacre.
The massacre, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, you know, where they screamed out, lay the Hodges on cardboard as payback for 9/11, basically,
Precisely.
And then massacred these people.
Right.
So this is the people that we're embracing and saying, not only are we embracing, but the same people who, you know, you hope that maybe know something about the Sermon on the Mount, these are the people that they're paying money to train them.
Correct.
They're taking parishioners' money, giving him to the basically psycho murderers,
yes,
and saying, you know, we want you to help train our people. I have a hard time. I'm amazed that there's not more outrage about this whole Blackwater
thing. The whole idea of one faith-based warfare is a horrible idea. The faith-based warfare for profit is even a worse idea. It's you know, horror upon horror upon horror. And again, we're still paying them there, and they still have government contracts. They're still, again, in Iraq.
And they still have a 34-count indictment for murder, and that's okay with our people.
True, totally. And again.
Oh, Jesus Christ. But then you were going to talk about Acorn. Let's contrast that.
Yeah, totally. So like we let Blackwater keep going after you know, murder and death and stuff. But like Acorn has this little video scandal, which again, it's not like it's nothing happened there. But Congress takes immediate action and votes to strip all federal funds from Acorn. But here's the thing, Pap, and the wording of the bill is actually, here's where the beauty comes in, though. The wording of this bill to strip Acorn's funding is actually so broad that if Congress were to follow it, they would have to sever ties to like all businesses and contractors who've had like much like shadier past than Acorn actually does. The bill actually says, Pap, that no federal funds can go to any organization that's been charged with breaking federal law or election laws, lobbying disclosure laws or like campaign finance laws, or filing fraudulent paperwork with any federal or state agency.
So there goes Halliburton, AT&T,
precisely.
Northrop. Okay, now who's doing something about that?
Okay, it's a guy from down in Florida with you, Representative Grayson.
Yeah, Democrat.
Yeah, exactly. He's actually put together a list online of all the corporations that technically should be stripped of federal funds. And here's like Acorn,
because they've been charged with filing fraudulent paperwork.
Precisely.
They have been indicted.
On all types of things.
So, they've been investigated. I mean, that's the beauty of this whole thing. I mean, if this plays out like it could be very positive.
If it plays out, it technically could kill the military-industrial complex. Mm. I mean, it could just like end it right here.
Or maybe bring some honest people into the business. Who knows?
Unfortunately, I kind of doubt that's going to happen. But I mean, if it goes that way. But hey, real quick, just so Grayson actually said the other day, just to put all this stuff into context with Acorn scandal and all the other horrible contractors going on. So the money that Acorn's received in the last 20 years altogether, this is what Grayson said, it's roughly equal to what taxpayers paid Halliburton on a single day during the war in Iraq.
Mm.
Actually, okay, so in the last in the last 15 years, Acorn's received a total of $53 million over the last 15 years.
Mm.
Actually, Jeremy Scahill said that Blackwater alone currently owes the federal government $55 million for not fulfilling the terms of one of their contracts in Iraq.
Mm.
They blew one contract, and so they owe the government $55 million in fines.
But they're still out with 34 indictments, still, you know, working for Obama.
Exactly. And I think, like, not excusing the actions of the few, you know, the few Acorn workers who were caught on that video and stuff like that. But, I mean, you can see why the right...
Well, you know, wait, there's another part to that story. I don't know if you caught that. You know, one of the women that were actually on the video actually went to the police.
Yeah, exactly.
And said, look, I got a problem here. I feel like I'm kind of in a conflict situation. What do I do?
No,
now, that part of the story, you know, when these numbskulls said, let's pull everything,
mm-hmm.
it's a classic congressional knee-jerk reaction.
Of course.
Without having the facts, they're so damn worried about their, you know, the idiot constituents that don't understand or follow the story
mm-hmm.
that they do exactly what was done here.
Exactly.
So the good that comes out of this is that maybe if Alan Grayson gets his way, that we may have Lockheed Martin and Northrop and some of these people that have, you know, fraud cases against them, and some of them with indictments against them, kind of a who's who of weapon manufacturer defense contracts. They may have some splaining to do.
Exactly. Right? Actually, Media Matters did a study, too, Pap, looking at, say, Hannity and Glenn Beck's coverage of Acorn compared to all the military contractor scandals. Okay, here's some facts here for you. Since May 2006, combined, the two of them referenced Acorn 1,502 times. They referenced Halliburton, KBR, and Blackwater combined, Pap, 47 times. Mm. Even though, again, these war profiteers have received tens of billions of government contracts and dollars compared to Acorn's $53 million over 15 years, which accounts to, like, I guess, like $3.5 million per year.
Right, right. Hey, let's take a quick break. We'll be right back.